Welcome to the guide of installing ProMods. Here, I will guide you through everything you need to know and do to correctly run ProMods. This video will be divided in main topics, so you can skip to the one you need. I remember back to the time I was a beginner in ATS2. It took me quite a bit to understand what ProMods was. Essentially, this is a mod for the game. This mod adds more cities and roads to the default game map. And you can see the map size difference here. Even though I will cover what you need to do to install this mod in game, if you want to install any other type of mod in ATS2, please feel free to visit the guide I put together. In the video, you will learn how to install any type of mod in this game. Link is in the description. If you are new to the game, I advise you to first enjoy the game default map first, and only then try this map. First, you need to know if you have everything you need to run this map. The game itself, by default, only brings a few European countries. Although, that is not enough if you want to install ProMods. SES, the creator of Euro Truck, has been releasing map DLCs for some time now. And if you want to run ProMods, you need them. All, most likely. At the time I'm making this video, we are running on the 1.46 version of ATS2. Therefore, I should only use ProMods update for this version on. As of now, I only need these DLCs. As you are watching this video from the future, you will need another DLCs. To check what DLCs you need, check this page. Link is in the description. Why you need DLCs, you might ask. You need all the DLCs because of two main reasons. One, it allows the modders to use SES assets like houses, trees and other objects, which the map modders will waste less time producing these for the map, and trust me, they save a lot of time. The second reason is consequently will decrease the download size of the mod, since you already have the models that are in the mod. First, you need to generate the dev file. You click in generate your dev file. Here, I usually leave it as default and only click in generate. One option to be aware is the special transport DLC or the if you want to install more map mods, check that box. Tick the boxes you need if you want to use it and if you have the DLC. For the other options, I don't think you should mess with it for now. Click in generate and it will download the dev file for you. Keep that around because you will need it. Then we proceed to the step 2. For the download, you have two options to download. One is by downloading 9 parts for free. The other way is paying 1 euro for one file, which helps the creators behind the map. At the time I'm making this video, there is no distinction between the two versions, only the way you download and the amount of work and time needed to download. But let's get more detailed. To download for free, you need to download the mod in parts. At the time, it's only 9 parts. Be aware that downloading this way, you can only download 2 parts at the same time. When one finishes, you can start downloading another one. Although, be aware that when a new version is launched, sometimes the download gets restricted at one file at a time, since the servers have to serve a lot of people. Don't spam it too much, otherwise you will get a timeout, and it will take a while before you can download it again. To download the paid version, it's pretty much straightforward. You click in Premium Download, and then Full Mod in one archive link. It will open another website and you get to pay 1 euro for the premium download. This way only brings upsides. You help the creators, it downloads way faster, one file and you're done. Either the free or paid version, you will need to put files in the mod folder. But first you need the mod folder. If this is the first time you are installing a mod, you need to go to My Documents, Euro Truck folder. Here you should have a mod folder. If you don't see one, you create it. Make sure the name of the folder is like this, lower level case and no blank spaces. This is where you're going to place the map files. Now we have 9 files here. What now? There are 2 ways to work with this. One, you can open one zip at a time and move the files inside to a folder. Or you can do my favorite way. For this, you need 7-zip. You select all the files you want to extract, you right-click 7-zip and select this option. 7-zip will compress all files for you and create a folder for it. Once the decompress is done, all you need to do is move the files inside the folder to the mod folder. Make sure you only move the SES files. And don't forget about the dev file you downloaded previously, if you haven't done it yet. One file only. This way, it only brings the zip and all you need to do is move the files inside to the mod folder. Once again, make sure you only move the SES files and the dev file, otherwise it won't work. Once the mod is in the mod folder, now in-game, you need a profile to play with it. In case you already have a profile where you have been playing, you can put promos there. It will be a mess. You need to create a new profile to use promos from scratch. To create a new profile, first load up the map in the mod manager. Make sure you load it up using the correct order. The order will be at page 3 of the download page. By now, you can copy my load order, but in the future it might change. That said, always check the add page. Now fill up all the info, like any other profile you want to create in this game. And you're done. If the game takes ages to load up the save, that is normal. The map is huge and it has a lot of assets. Everything has to be loaded, so take this moment and get up, do some push-ups or go for a mini walk. If the game crashes, something is wrong, but try loading it up again. The most likely scenario is that you either don't have a DLC, which is required, or the load order isn't correct. Also, it may be some corrupted file. I doubt the promos team will upload a faulty file, as I'm sure the map is tested really well before it gets released. If everything is right and it still doesn't work, I would re-download all files again and try again. For promos, there are map add-ons you can use. From the promos team itself, you might even get the Middle East expansion, which is being developed. Although, it is possible to mix other maps as well. Be aware that not all maps mix. For instance, the one-to-one maps are incompatible with promos. There are plenty of maps and add-ons you can get. And in this case, you can add them anytime you want. Make sure the add-on map is done for the version of promos and the game version you are using. To install the map mod, it's pretty simple. Assuming you have done everything I covered previously, to install these add-ons, you need to repeat the process for the maps. You download them by parts or not, extract the files or not, and place the files in the mod folder. Then you activate in-game on top of promos map. Be aware that some map mods also require a certain load order. That load order should be somewhere in the download page. Usually, every time a new game update comes out, it takes a bit of time for promos team to get the map updated. During this time, you either patiently wait for the new promos version to come out, or you downgrade your game to continue playing in the map version you currently have. Also, every time a new update gets released, you will not lose your profile. That said, once the new promos version gets released, you will have to download all files again and repeat the extraction progress. After this, before you load up the profile, make sure the map is loaded correctly in the mod manager of the respective profile. As you probably will use other mods with the profile, be careful with the mods you use. This because every new game update, and therefore promods update, some mods depending on the type of the game update will need to get updated as well. And if at the time promods release the new version and the other mods are not updated, you might get in trouble. That said, I think you now have everything it takes to start your prom journey. If I helped you, consider subscribing as well as liking this video. Also, if you wish I do another game tutorial or add any issues, please let me know in the comments section below. Thanks for watching, take care, bye.